हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ भूमिका एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द थर्ड चैप्टर ऑफ कंप्यूटर विच इज़ कॉल्ड कीबोर्ड. सी हियर, अ कीबोर्ड इज़ अ डिवाइस दैट कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ नंबर ऑफ कीज. इट हेल्प्स अस टू टाइप, गिव कमांड्स, प्ले गेम्स एंड मूव फ्रॉम वन पॉइंट टू अनदर. We type on a computer by pressing the keys on the keyboard of a computer. Whatever we type on the keyboard appears on the monitor. In the previous class, children, we have already learned that what is keyboard, what are the main parts of the computer, the monitor, the keyboard, the mouse, what all these things are. We have already learned, okay? Now we are going to learn about the keyboard in more detail. Basically, what is keyboard? Whatever we want to see on the monitor, all that thing, whatever we want to see on the monitor, we need to type something, right? We need to write on the monitor. How will write? We cannot write with pencil or pen on the monitor, right? So what we'll do? We will type on in the keyboard. Whenever we press any key on the keyboard, whichever key we are pressing, that particular thing or a word or a letter is appearing on the monitor. So, we type on a computer by pressing the keys on the keyboard of a computer. Whatever we type on the keyboard appears on the monitor. Now, what this boy is saying? I know that a keyboard has alphabet keys, number keys, enter keys, a space bar. And what this toggle is saying? Let us now learn about some more keys on the keyboard. So basically, you also like this boy, you also may be knowing about these keys, right? Alphabet keys, like you have seen that ABC, the QWERTY keyboard is there. The keyboard starts with Q, W, E, R, okay, in the first line. So all these keys are alphabet keys. Now, second is on the right hand side of the keyboard, you will see the number keys are there. A big long space bar key is there, and a big enter key is also present on the keyboard on which it is written enter. So you are very well aware of these keys. Now we are going to learn about some more keys. Over here you can see on this keyboard, see a keyboard. Over here it is shown, here this one, the big one is the space bar key, here this is the enter key. Here also there is another enter key, okay? All these keys, are the alphabet keys, okay? And you are very well aware of all these things. A keyboard generally has 104 keys. Now if you will count all these keys altogether, then you will come to know that these are 104 keys. They are generally, there may be different also, one or two more or less keys also, depending on the type of keyboard. Okay, moving to the next one, cursor control keys. A cursor is a small blinking line on the monitor that shows the position of the next letter or number to be entered. The cursor looks like this. See, this this symbol is of the cursor. Okay, over here you can see, if this boy is typing on the key in the keyboard, whatever he is typing, it is appearing on the monitor, and on the monitor a blinking, small blinking line is there. So this shows the position. ये एक position बताता है कि आप कहाँ पर लिखना चाह रहे हो. मॉनिटर में ये कर्सर जहाँ भी होगा उस पोजिशन पर आप लिख रहे हो. ओके, सो दिस इज़ दी कर्सर. अ कर्सर कंट्रोल कीज, ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एरो कीज, आर यूज for moving the cursor on the monitor. So basically you can move this cursor with the help of this mouse, but you can also move this cursor, this blinking line, with the help of these four keys: the up key, the left key, the right key and the down key. All these four keys are helping you. So if you want to move your cursor on the first line, you are at the bottom of the page and you want to go at the on the first line, then what you will do, you will press this up key and your cursor will move upside. Similarly, if you want to go down, you will press this down key. If you want to go on the left side of your page or left side of your line at the very first point of your line, then you will press this left key. Similarly, if you want to go right, you will press this right key. All these keys are called the arrow keys. Okay, all these keys are the arrow keys. The arrows marked on the keys show the direction in which the cursor moves when those keys are pressed. So these arrows marked on the keys are showing the direction. So if you want to go down, so you can see that in this arrow key, if you want to go down, this down arrow is shown. If you want to go on the right side, then right arrow is shown on this arrow key. If you want to go up, then up arrow is shown in this key, right? So in the same way, whichever arrow is marked on the key, you can go in that particular direction. There is one more key, which is the backspace key. Okay, suppose you are writing something and by mistake you have mistyped anything. There is a typo. Okay, you have typed wrong any alphabet. Suppose the spelling of keyboard is KEYBOARD and you have typed Y two times. Now you want to erase that another Y, which is wrong. So what you will do? You will bring that cursor to that Y as shown in this figure. See, in this figure it is shown. You will bring that cursor to here Y and you will press this backspace key. As soon as you will press this backspace key, the other Y which is wrongly typed will be deleted. Okay, so in this way you can correct the spelling. So backspace key is basically used for correcting your spellings or whatever wrong things you have typed or whatever you have mistyped over there. When pressed, the backspace key erases anything typed on the left side of the cursor. So backspace key always erases on the left side. If you will press this cursor on the right of this Y and if you will try to erase using the backspace key, then it will not erase this last Y, it will erase the first Y. Okay, in this example you need to correct the spelling of keyboard to keyboard. Okay, here double Y is there, you can notice over here, and here only one Y is there. You need to correct the spelling. What you will do? You will press the cursor to the second Y over here, the last Y. Position the cursor after the first Y and then use the backspace key to erase the extra Y. Then there is another one, delete key. Okay, here you can see this type of key is delete. On this it is written D-E-L-E-T-E, delete. Okay, that means whenever you are pressing a cursor, again it is its function is just like the backspace key. If you have mistyped anything, if you want to correct the spelling, then you can use this key also. When pressed, the delete key erases anything typed on the right side of the cursor. In case of backspace key, we have seen that it will erase on the left side of the cursor. While using the delete key, it will erase on the right side of the cursor. In this example, you need to correct the spelling of monitor, M-O-R-C. In monitor, R never comes, right? So this is the wrong spelling and you want to correct it to monitor. What you will do? Position the cursor after the first O. See, after this first O, if you will position the monitor as shown in this figure, see here over here. You are pressing this cursor after the first O and then you are pressing this delete key. What will happen? The R, which is there, which is wrongly typed, will get deleted, will be erased. So position the cursor of the first O and then use the delete key to erase the R. Another key is the caps lock key. Okay, so here you can see there on the keyboard there used to be some these lightings. Whenever these keys are pressed, means whenever these keys are on, then a green light will blink, and whenever that keys are off, that green light will go off. You can see over here, if it is shown, let me show you. See over here, this one on the keyboard, you will find that 1, 2, and 3 green lights are there. That means on, and over here it is written num lock, caps lock and scroll lock. Okay, that means if these three lights are blinking on, they are light on, that means these functions are working. Num lock is basically for these numbers. These number keys you can only use whenever this num lock light is on. दिस कैप्स लॉक, वेन एवर यू प्रेस दिस की, कैप्स लॉक की ओवर हियर, यू विल सी दैट दिस लाइट विल टर्न ऑन, एंड वेन द कैप्स लॉक इज टर्न ऑन, ऑल दिस लेटर्स विल बी इन कैपिटल लेटर्स. वेन एवर यू विल टाइप एनी ऑफ दिस लेटर्स, इट विल बी इन कैपिटल लेटर्स, बट वेन एवर दिस कैप्स लॉक की इज ऑफ, ऑल दिस लेटर्स विल बी इन स्मॉल लेटर्स. एंड स्क्रोल लॉक मीन्स वंस वेन यू आर टाइपिंग एंड वेन यू आर कंप्लीटेड वन पेज, यू आर मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट पेज. Now you want to again go up, that means you will scroll up. You will go up, that means you will scroll up. But if you want to lock that one, you don't want to go up and down, you don't want to scroll, then you can press this, you can switch on this scroll lock and you can stop the scrolling also. Okay. Now again, we were over here on the caps lock. When the caps lock key is on, all the letters that are typed appear in capitals on the monitor. So whatever you are typing, that will appear in capital. See over here, caps lock, it is also written in capital. Why? Because caps lock is on. For example, if you type the word mouse, okay, you are typing this word, it will appear as mouse or everything in capital on the monitor. Why? Because your caps lock is turned on, your green light is blinking. When the caps lock key is off, the letters that are typed appear in small letters on the monitor. And whenever these keys are, the caps lock is off like this, at that time what will happen? All the keys, whatever you will type, that will be in the small letters. Nothing will be in the capital letter. For example, if you type the word printer, it will appear in small letter printer. It is not shown. I'm so sorry for that. So on this keyboard you will see this yellow marked are, first one here it is a caps lock key, the backspace key and the delete key. Okay, so all these three keys are positioned over here, and we have already learned about the enter key over here, another enter key over here, the space bar over here. These all four are the arrow keys, right? So we have learned about these keys. Moving to the next one, that is num lock. I have already shown in previous keyboard, the first page, what is num lock. When you are clicking on the num lock key and the light, when the key is on, the light, green light blinks, that means you can use these these number keys. Otherwise, if this is off, you cannot use this number key. Even when this light is off and when you are pressing these keys, what happens? You are not able to see these numbers on the monitor. Okay, on the screen you will not be able to see this. So that means if you want to use these number keys, if you want to type any of these numbers, you have to first of all switch on this num lock key, and then only you will be able to see it on the monitor. So num lock key, it is written like this over here. You can see on the num lock key, NUMLOCK num lock. Okay, if you want to use the numeric keypad, this keypad is called the numeric keypad. On the right side of the keyboard, the num lock key should be on. The numeric keypad and the num lock key are shown in this figure. So what this boy is saying now? Hey friends, I also know how to type numbers. Everyone knows, right? Now everyone knows. Now another special key is a shift key over here. When you are pressing a shift key, so okay, let us read first of all. The shift key is used along with other keys. See, if you are pressing shift key alone, nothing will happen. Okay, it is always pressed along with the other keys, means shift key by one hand, with the other hand you will press any other key. Okay, there are two shift keys on a keyboard. Okay, one is over here and the other is over here. There are two shift keys on the keyboard and both of them have the same function. Both the shift keys are having the same function. Okay, there is nothing difference in that, no difference in both the shift keys. One is on the left side and one is on the right side. When you want to type the upper symbol of any of the keys colored orange, use the shift key. See, you will see that these orange color keys have two symbols. Okay, here 1, 2, 3 are written, and on the upper side of it, the at the right mark, exclamation mark, and many other symbols are there. When you want to type these upper symbols, what you will do? You can, if you will press this key alone, this orange key is alone, at that time you won't be able to see these things. You will not be able to press that symbols. For pressing that symbol, you have to type shift first and then you have to type this whichever symbol you want to. Okay, so shift key always works with the other keys. The upper symbols are typed using the shift key. For example, if you want to type the symbol star, okay, press the shift key along with the key that has the symbol, that is the sixth key from the right. Okay, over here if you want to type the symbol star, what you will do, you will type this shift key and along with this shift key you will press this symbol of star, the sixth key from here. Okay, this star and shift, both the keys will be like this, both together you will be clicking and then you will be able to see the star symbol on the monitor screen. Another one key is tab key. Okay, it is basically over here, tab key over here. The tab key is present on the left side of the keyboard. On the left side of the keyboard you can see this tab key. It moves the cursor to the right by many spaces. For example, type your first name and then press the tab key. See the cursor move by many spaces. See, if you are pressing this space bar, what will happen? You will be able to leave space one or two as much as words, one or two letters or alphabets may occupy. But when you are tapping on the tab key, at that time what happens, a lot of space is left, a big space is left and you can move forward or move ahead. Okay, so it moves the cursor to the right by many space, and specifically the cursor is moving to the right by leaving so much of space, lot of space. Okay, for example, type your first name and then press tab key. See the cursor move by many spaces. See here, Meenal Seth, that name is typed, and after typing Meenal, instead of tapping on the space bar, if you are tapping on the tab key, at that time there is lot of spaces left in between Meenal and Seth. Another key is the escape key, which is over here. You can see the escape key is shown over here. So what is the function of escape key? The escape key is used to close a menu or a dialog box. It is present on the upper left corner of the keyboard. On the upper left corner of the keyboard you can see the escape key. For what it is used? To close a menu or a dialog box. Anything, if it has it is open, and if you want to close any menu or any dialog box or anything that is appearing, if you want to close that, at that time what you will press, you will press the escape key, ESC. It is shown by ESC. For example, if you have clicked the start button by mistake, okay, by mistake you have clicked on a start button, what you will do, do not want to work with the start menu, just press the escape key and the menu will disappear. You have to just click on the escape key and the menu, because you don't want to, you are working on your page, you are typing something, and now you have pressed on the start menu, it is opening, but you don't want that. What you will do, you will simply press on the escape key and that one will disappear. Okay, so what all we have learned? The escape key, the tab key, okay, then the space bar key, the caps lock key, the shift key, the num lock, okay, and what else, the delete key also we have learned over here, how to delete, and the backspace key also we have learned today, and the four arrows over here to move the cursor, right? And these are the special keys of the keyboard. So now you are knowing about many things about the keyboard, the escape key, then over here the alphabets key, the caps lock, the shift, here another shift, enter, backspace, again enter, the four arrow keys, the delete key, num lock key over here, and when you are pressing this caps lock, then the light turns on and turns off. That's all for today. Thank you.